Channel 5, NBC Chicago.
Hi, I'm Bob Pittman. This morning on Album Tracks, we'll have news of Yes, Chicago, and Brand X. We'll also have summer concert info for you, new albums due for release, and a profile of Todd Rundgren. Now, according to Record World magazine, the top four selling albums in the country this week are number four, Feel So Good from Chuck Mangione, number three, Showdown from the Isley Brothers, number two is Wings' London Town, and number one is once again Saturday Night Fever featuring the Bee Gees and various artists. Now, if you've been wondering how your favorite radio station stacks up against the other radio stations in the country, here's the top five most played albums on the progressive radio stations, according to Radio and Records magazine. Number five is the Atlanta Rhythm Section, Champagne Jam. Number four, Warren Zevon's Excitable Boy. Number three, the soundtrack of the movie FM. Number two, Jefferson Starship's Earth. And number one, Wings' London Town. Other albums getting lots of airplay are Son of a Sailor, that's from Jimmy Buffett, City to City from Jerry Rafferty, and Stone Blue from Foghat. And now with news about Yes and the new tax crunch on English musicians, here's Album Tracks' Lee Masters. Lee?
A lot of rock and roll fans are going crazy over the Martin Scorsese film The Last Waltz, which captures the festivities and the music of the band's last performance. However, one man is particularly unhappy, and that's rock promoter Bill Graham. He's the one responsible for producing the concert. Graham overhauled the Winterland Auditorium for the show. He served a full-course Thanksgiving dinner for 5,000 people and hired an orchestra to play waltzes for the crowd. None of that showed up in the film, and he claims his help and involvement was not even acknowledged. After spending over 2 years in Switzerland, Yes has returned to their home in London to record their follow-up album to Going for the One. They've come up with more than 24 songs. John Anderson says he wants to record them all. They're working every day now from noon until early evening at AdVision Studios in London. This is their 10th year together, and they plan an anniversary celebration concert in London sometime this summer. Rehearsals are going on for the Jefferson Starship as they get ready for their European tour coming up. This time out, they're experimenting with equipment modules. That's going to cut down on the stage setup time. If it works, you can look for other bands to use a similar system. And at the famous Criteria Studios in Miami, Chicago is working on their latest album. It'll be the first one not produced by James Gorsio. Yes, there have been a lot of Bee Gees or Bee Gees sounding records on the singles charts lately. Gibbs songs have dominated the number one spot on the singles chart every week but one since mid-December. This kind of dominance hasn't been seen since George Martin and the Beatles did it in the mid-60s. But one bit of Beatlemania that isn't making it is the movie I Want to Hold Your Hand. It's a stiff. Steven Spielberg, who's been raking in the chips with Jaws and Close Encounters of the Third Kind, is having massive problems getting people interested in this film about some Beatles fanatics. He's even considering withdrawing that film from circulation. Robin Lumley and Woody Denard have left the jazz rock band Brand X. Lumley will do production work. Peter Robinson of Go and Al Stewart's band will replace him. Chuck Berge, formerly with Al DiMeola of Chick Corea's band, will be replacing Denard. For years, English rock stars have tried to avoid the crunch of the British tax laws, for some as much as 83%, by moving to America. This soon may end. After the Memorial Day recess, the Senate will vote on a measure that would have any American or English entertainer earning more than $15,000 on each other's soil taxed in both countries. This would not just apply to musicians, but also actors, athletes, any highly paid performer, regardless of the amount of time he spends in either country.
Schomburg, Dotson wants your business, and here's proof. For starters, prices start at just $3,154 for a Dotson B210 Honeybee, plus nominal dealer prep and local taxes. What's more, they'll include free air conditioning on any 810 in stock, a value up to $500. These prices may increase, so don't miss out. See why Schomburg Dotson's becoming the big name in the small car world. Schomburg Dotson, 910 West Golf Road in Schomburg.
It's a small car world.
The Park West is always the first to bring you the finest in entertainment. Here's some upcoming events at the Park West. Appearing May 31st is Sergio Mendez, Brazil 88, and Procter & Bergman on June 3rd. Also at the Park West is Flora Purim, June 16th, Peebo Bryson, June 17th, and Rick Saucedo, June 18th. Laura Nyro, July 5th, and Ashford & Simpson on July 22nd and 23rd. Tickets available at Ticketron outlets in the Park West box office. For information, call 929-5959.
Hurry to Exposition Carpet for excellent values during their spring cleaning sale. Right now, their entire inventory of completely reconditioned carpeting in almost every size, color, and texture is selling for as much as 50% below dealer's cost. So hurry into Exposition Carpet and save. Exposition Carpet, 5718 North Broadway.
There's not a better place in town to get your carpeting down than Exposition Carpet.
I've discovered a camera, the Vivitar. It's a pocket camera with a great idea. The electronic flash is built in, see? Now my flash pictures don't have to be blurry or fuzzy because somebody moved. There's a sharp Vivitar picture for you. And here's the Vivitar. Small, inexpensive, so easy. Nothing to attach. The flash is built in. If you want sharp pictures, this has got to be your camera.